Ano ba ang dapat tutukan ng papasok na Department of Tourism Secretary?
Okay. Una-una yung ano yung ngayon maganda yung ano nang pangyayari kasi bukas na lahat talaga yung turismo, eh, no? I think what is important is to sustain that na you know dapat merong close coordination pa rin sa ibang branches of government to ensure that the pandemic will not allow another lockdown kasi yun talaga ang pinakamalaking ano malaking balakid sa rebound ng turismo. So I think it is important to ensure that proper protocols are still followed as far as kahit na nagluwag na tayo ng mga restrictions, eh maingat pa rin tayo.
So that's one, yung ilabi na na wag nang mag-lockdown for tourism.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else? What about infrastructure? I understand nung nawala pala ako, partner, may naging issue pala sa NAIA na worse pa tayo sa ano yun? Para nakita ko business lounges,
class
travel.
Lounge.
That is also part of tourism kasi may sector sa tourism na medyo high-end na gusto naman nila, pampered naman sila, hindi ba, Richie?
I guess there's a degree of truth to that, no? If you look at yung mga facilities for premium class travels sa mga airport natin, and if you compare it to other airports in other countries, eh medyo malayo, and there's a lot to be desired as far as kahit yung mga business class lounges natin dito sa mga airports natin, sana ma-upgrade din yan. But again, it all depends on the airport authorities at saka sa mga respective airlines also kasi sila rin ang gumagastos diyan.
Correct.
Anything
more
else?
On the airlines, di ba? Sila kanila yon eh, yung mga lounges na yan. Okay. Ano
anything
pa po?
Anything else, Richie? Yung mga manggagawa, yung mga maraming na walang ng trabaho, yung mga manggagawa sa turismo.
Yan, isa pa. No? I mean, I think, tingin ko kailangan natin mag-ano, the government should look into incentivizing or ano, just like what other countries are doing, no? If you compare again the prices of our hotels in the country and compared to our neighboring countries, medyo nasa kamahalan yung mga hotels natin. I'm talking about both inbound and local tourism, no? Yung mga ano natin, I think ang operation ng cost ng hotel, I can understand, might be very high. And I think this is where the government can come in, that they can put some incentives in terms of tax relief or incentive on electricity, whatever there is. No, I mean, of course, I cannot detail on that. The government would be in a better position to look into those. Ano, but these are just ideas thrown in the air. Na probably would ano, if the hotels can save on those, then probably they can drop their prices as well and make it more attractive to both local and foreign tourists.
So ano kaya magiging target ng next na tourism secretary? Kasi hindi ba pag kinumpira natin yung sarili natin halimbawa sa Thailand, aba, parang malayo na yung agwat natin sa Thailand, ano? Mas talagang doble na ba ng turista na nila ang turista natin o triple?
Triple pa ata. I mean the number of tourists, I mean siguro it's better to compare pre-COVID, no? Kasi iba talaga ang sitwasyon nung nagka-pandemic. Eh lahat naman talaga naapektuhan, but pre-COVID ang turismo ng Thailand ay talagang napakalayo kumpara sa number of tourists natin na pumapasok
sa bansa.
So
anong ginagawa nila, Richie, na hindi natin ginagawa? Bakit ganun sila karami? Ba't tayo ganito lang?
I guess yun nga, mabalik tayo dun sa cost ng travel into our country compared to the other countries. The value per dollar when they spent it in Thailand is more than compared to spending it in the Philippines. Unang-una, napakamahal ng mga hotels natin.
Okay. Yung Richie, yung sinabi ko, yung merong grupo, isang grupo doon sa Palawan na humihiyaw sila na mukhang nabalahura yung koron at kinalbo yung bundok dahil meron yatang development project doon. Pero ang sinasabi, ang claim is hindi alam ng LGU yung ginawang proyekto na yun. So, paano kaya yun kailangang tutukan ng bagong tourism chief?
You know, the still current administration, no, have always looked at into ano, protectionism of tourism. So ayan nga ginawa ni Presidente Duterte sa Boracay, talagang in-insure niya na talagang hindi ibalik sa maayos na, no. So I think we should continue that, not only for Boracay but for all the other tourism sites. I'm not sure about, I'm not privy to the whole story of that, the one in Palawan, but any projects I'm quite doubtful na hindi alam ng ano, hindi alam ng local government if there is a project going on. If it's not known to them immediately, it should not take time for them to know about it and do something about it as well.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Partner?
So ano pa yung recommendation niyo sa, kilala niyo ba itong si incoming secretary Frasco?
No, not personally, but of course she has been on the news as the VP elect Sara's spokesperson, no? And she was also the mayor, she's the mayor of Liloan in Cebu. Oh. Yun lang ang, and she's a lawyer, I understand. So
pero okay ba kayo sa kanya or meron pa kayong nasa isip na mas nasa palagay ninyo as ay mas akma sa portfolio ng Department of Tourism?
I think we should approach it in a more positive note, no. I mean the appointment of Attorney Frasco or Mayor Frasco, I'm sure has been well thought by whoever by the president elect and his team. So I think let's give it a good vibe. Let's take it positively and see what she can offer for the department.
Ako mga welcome. Parang ganun yung attitude.
Yes,
welcome
yes.
her and uh-oh. Engage her and join her in mm-hmm. doing something for our tourism sector. Parang ganun ang attitude.
Tingnan ko ano magagawa.
That is correct. I mean, you know, we cannot discount what she can or what she can't do. So you know, let's welcome her and let her do what she can do. And as far as the department is concerned, definitely there's a lot of tasks that still needs to be done. Secretary Berna has done quite a number of initiatives, especially during this pandemic. And thanks to her, and hopefully the new department secretary will carry on, will elevate further the status of the tourism industry in the Philippines.
Okay.